so grateful and humbled that y'all were here, and help me welcome your new head basketball coach.
The fact that whenever I had conversations with our administrative team, you know, the things that they were bringing up, you know, talking about culture, talking about family, those were things that kind of are the backbone of who I am as a coach. And I know that those are the key elements that you need to be able to have a successful program. So those were the big reasons why I was willing to get out here and take this jump at Broken Arrow and do everything we can to, you know, take it to the next level. You know, the women's game has evolved. It's been fun to watch. The game has gotten quicker. You know, the girls, their skill level has increased as a whole. You know, and you put those two together, I think they're making strides to get even closer to the men's game itself. You know, and you watch right now, you know, in the NCAA tournament, you know, I saw today that, you know, the women's side, the ratings, you know, TV ratings are through the roof right now. And that right there is going to do nothing but just continue to elevate the high school game, the junior high game, you know, little girls at the age of 6 and 7 that want to maybe someday have that opportunity to play at that level. We're going to have a team that's going to be very, very one passion. You know, they're going to play hard. They're going to play with a lot of energy. They're going to be energetic in the way that they're going to communicate with one another. We're going to want to play a team. And one of the things I need to understand is I got to watch these guys a little bit before I tell you exactly how we want to play. But my dream style is to get up and down the floor and to really get after them on the defensive side of the floor and mix some things up, obviously, on the defensive side. But need to really sit down with them and just kind of see where we are before I really make those true adjustments. For a program to be successful, I feel like they've got to, our players here at Broken Arrow have got to be able to see myself in a different light other than just being a coach. They've got to see, you know, me as a father, you know, with my own children and as a husband. You know, one of my biggest goals is to be a role model. You know, my wife is going to be huge, you know, in this aspect. She has been so involved while we were in Edwin Memorial, just doing little things for our players, you know, whether we had events that we hosted, you know, at our house or things along those lines. She's always been that caregiver. And the one thing I've always loved about her is she's always kind of, you know, been that balancing act for me. She's been that rock, you know, to kind of tell me when I need to slow down just a little bit and how to maybe deal with a certain situation with players. And she is the most valuable player on the team in my books, for sure. I know I had the opportunity today to visit with our staff, and I was able to kind of get to know them a little bit. And I know next week, you know, hopefully the plan is to get out here and have an opportunity to be able to work with these kids a little bit and just kind of see where they are, number one, and then begin to kind of lay the foundation, you know, of what we expect to do. And I know we'll have tryouts in May, so some people will be coming in from other sports and all that. But the foundation of what we want to do with our program, is we're going to start laying that out here in the next few weeks.
He was actually in Edmond Public Schools for 17 years, served as a teacher, a coach. Legendary coach Mike De La Garza gave him his shot, saw something in him as a young coach. And for those of you who are aware of Coach De La Garza, he's one of the staples in the state of Oklahoma. He did things the right way. He built a program for a long time, decades of dominance. And that's kind of that tree that Coach comes from. And as a coach, that means a lot. That tree means everything. Because that's, you're going to always fall back on where you came from and how you learned and what matters most in developing young people. You know, I talked to a longtime friend of mine this morning, and she coaches in the Big 12. I spent 4 years on staff with Coach at TU, but here's what she had to say, and he doesn't know this, but this is what she had to say about him. He's got a great offensive mind. He loves building relationships with his players and staff. He's family-oriented first and foremost. His wife and kids will always be around the program. He is passionate about the game of basketball and helping players develop on and off the court. He loves investing in coaches. He wants to win. He built a winning program at Edmond Memorial and knows what it takes to develop players to win championships.
When I was going through this process of you know, learning about the BA job and learning if it was what I really wanted to do, there were two things that stuck out to me amongst our leadership team here at Broken Arrow. And I'm going to share those two with you. One of our conversations that we had, we were talking about programs and visions and what you want to be able to do to kind of build something successful. And the big thing that they were able to kind of talk to me about and the terms that they were bringing up was the BA culture. And that right there, my eyebrow rose right there at that moment, because I realized this, as a leader, I understand the importance of what culture means to be able to take a program to the next level. That's what put me in the intrigue mode, all right? But what sealed it for me was a simple conversation, but it happened multiple times, and he used the term right up here immediately, family. Family is the basis to everything that you want to do when it comes to success. You know, you take that culture, you take the family atmosphere that we're going to build here at Broken Arrow, you're going to be able to put yourself in a position, guys, where we're going to be so successful, and we're going to put ourselves in a position where we're going to be the very best team you possibly can be. So I'm so excited, and I think, you know, you guys as leaders, you know, to have that mentality, it makes me just kind of thrilled to know that I'm going to be part of your family. But the big thing I want you guys to understand, you know, going in, I know transition is crazy. There's uncertainty. You don't know what's going to happen. You don't know what this coach is going to be like. But I'm going to tell you this, okay, right now. I'm a coach that is very, very passionate. I'm a coach of high, high energy. You're going to see me in that gym every day selling it out and giving my all to you every day, okay? I want you guys to understand that our expectation as a staff, I was able to visit with our staff earlier today, and I thought it was an awesome experience to kind of get to know some of them a little bit, but we're all going to be on the same page, all right? And our goal is to put Broken Arrow back on the map, okay, in women's basketball, okay? We're going to be mentioned as contenders for state titles on a year-in, year-out basis. That is our goal. That is our mission, okay? I'm sure everybody in here would love to say, that's what I want too, okay? And that is awesome. But you guys got to understand, just because you want something doesn't mean it's going to just automatically, magically appear. We've got to make sure we're working really, really hard. Every time I sign a note, I write think excellence, because I think that's a mentality, okay? And that's something that I'm going to expect of you guys every day when we get in on the floor, is to play with a high level of excellence. Are we going to be perfect every day? No. Are we going to learn though? Yes. Okay. That's something that means the world to me, and we're going to give it your all, okay, every day. Just know that, and know the dividends will be paid in the long run. When those dividends are going to be paid, not certain, okay, but wins will come. But the most important thing as we go along this process as well is developing you guys as great young women that are going to be ready to take on the world. But I cannot say this enough, how excited I am and how I'm ready to hit the ground running and get to work.
That is going to be called just when guys, if we're going to be good at anything we do defensively, we have to be able to incorporate some of these